Molecular biomarkers. quantum biomarkers. Also, there is a very broad use of the topic of digital biomarkers. We shall move to two new, not bring our schools in the definition of computational biomarkers, including what they are called, and also a completely new notion that is to be a first announcement that will be up at Springer the next days concerning biomarkers. So, all these are very nice classifications. This is the new paper, last 2017, that not only gives the type of biomarker and its use, but gives a definition of that and gives a specific example. This is crucial for all the learning biomarkers. This is not only his work, but this is the work of many labs, and the basic thing is of many clinical practice. The most concrete remark of what we can apply is only produced after clinical trials that have to be concentrated first on the classification of the biomarkers. The imaging biomarkers are also very well known, very well classified. It's how we can take from images parameters that the range of them can define if we have a process, a biological process that maybe needs normal or disease. Another table also from Germany last year, in July, a very interesting paper, and the very interesting notion here afterwards is the characteristic. So it's how you can find the biomarker, but mainly work on the characteristics of the COVID. This is very crucial for what we will do. What they mainly do now in the clinical trials is that they are going to have a biological and clinical validation that nearly stops after the first phase of working with that, and then have the technical validation of this, mainly based on biotechnology tools. So it's not research, it's tools and mainly machines, new machines that are working like the JPA for software, for example, that give us the characteristic without saying. Also, there is another parameter that we will see in some case studies concerning the cost effectiveness of all this work concerning the biomarkers. This is produced mainly in clinical oncology. There, of course, we have a special status. A special status is that we are working with mainly a unique biomarker that we're trying to come to this correlated to the disease. And this is mainly the work done up now for the precision medicine scheme that is working. These are mainly digital biomarkers, but digital biomarkers are made by mechanics. There is a problem. The problem is that the description does not follow the characteristic, and maybe it's not up to now. Only in 10 cases is related to the effectiveness of the biomarkers. Okay? So when they describe digital biomarkers, they do not have the range and they cannot follow up the patient. So I think that it's useless to talk about particular biomarkers, perhaps not to be known better than me. A successful case study. Let's move on to the digital biomarkers. Okay. This is very interesting because the definitions up to now for digital biomarkers is their description and the search that I used to provide. And mainly this is done by the digital devices that provide all those biomarkers. Could these devices be effective? Okay. can give us results in real time, can follow up the patient, can they be correlated with biological biomarkers, are they reliable, can they be used in clinical trials. All these are very crucial for the people that were against the digital biomarkers, as I was at the very beginning, back in 2004. Okay. So, in 2004, there was a very close successor of the leader now, working together also with the research and the professional biomarkers, and stuff like that, that we have a huge scientific network concerning that. I believe that only biological biomarkers provide us follow up of the mechanism, and he was very eager for introducing digital biomarkers from physiology when they neuromotor images. Finally, at the end, there is a convergence. This is what I'm going to do. Okay. So let us see how they are really aligned. So one very interesting diagnosis for breast cancer is introduced by Kuni Tekta in Switzerland, in Basel, where we're working together. And it has been produced, it's been was finally brought by Arthritis, another one. But what is mainly done is by using the soft molecules in the breast, we can provide a very high accuracy of the breast cancer. This is what I'm talking about. This is Andorra, this is my friend Alistair Munas, that won the EIT Prize Award last year with this. The 94% of accuracy from products in Alzheimer in 6 years ago. It has an FDA clearance from the SMOC. Yet to become this one and say that we have digital biomarkers, it has proceeded a joint work of clinical trials with my lab, the physiology lab, joining biological and digital biomarkers together. So, we have a scientific alliance which started to become huge for that year concerning all this. There are new analyses that I can go to you at the end of this webinar that are being announced in the next months. Antonio, sorry to say a few words. It's, you can have it in your portal, your iPhone, and from the physiology test. Subject can give you an exact 94% accuracy of if you an exact state of at risk for the people involved in the cancer.
He is the only one
from the biological mechanism, so the diagnosis research, and they are failing in complicating disease evolution, is a combination of one biomarker and one clinical test. So this mainly is working only for the 16% of cancer. And we have seen in the last 2 years contradictory results. So we have clinical trials for one biomarker that gives a positive answer and a negative answer at the same time. It's in the why do we go to computational biomarkers? By the need of having accuracy in what we agree in different levels. The first level is classification. The second level is how you can introduce all this inside a simple vector space. The third is how you can use all this vector space in order to produce functions on them that can give you results according to the biological mechanism. What can be done if you fail? The function of this vector space, and this function cannot work, or you are not able to make the modeling, how can you still access to the evolution of the biological mechanism afterwards? Those are the results that we use. And the third is, can you have in parallel work and have results in real time? Can you combine all these results and can you make a comparative study with others that are already classified? All these are the notions that give you a complexity of the biomarkers that you use also some special. The complexity is mainly due to two things. The correlation, which is not statistical. You do not use statistics, but you don't do probability, you do not use stochastic. The correlations between the biomarkers themselves and the functions that you are producing on them. To be more concrete, the study analysis that we are using, we mainly keep in our lab now, we are doing in the research center of computational biomarkers, six different stages. The first stage is we try to understand the biological mechanism and the correlation with specific biomarkers. This is mainly done by already existing studies from biologists or psychologists that are working in the lab for the biomarkers that are already involved in different clinical trials that we can have. The other is that we also try to enrich this set of data with exact exact identification of the different cases. So, if we have as a research result that there are 288 different cases in Alzheimer's, for example, we have to identify a person with this identity. It's a biomarker study. The third is we use all this as a system of biomarkers. This system of biomarkers is mainly expressed by two things. It's a vector space. You cannot avoid it. And the other, it should be time dependent. You cannot also avoid time dependent analysis. You cannot avoid continuous function, continuous data. It's crazy to work with these cases. So the main thing is we stay with the system of biomarkers and try to have computational tools that are combining all this. Computational tools are made for accuracy. They are used as modules for each biomarker in a huge system that will computationally follow the mathematical model that comes out. After all, so we have to derive a mathematical model and we have to work on the functions that are set on the system of biomarkers. See one by one. So the first is what I already told you, the first stage. It should be very careful, we should be very careful with the specificity for each biomarker, and also the levels of estimation that are already used before we enter them as data in our own system. The second stage has a necessity in this biomarker system that I told you about, and also needs tools that are not working for the simulation. All the well-known tools for simulation does not work because they are very basic linear algebra. So linear algebra can be expressed very highly as artificial intelligence and neural systems. Still linear algebra with linear combinations. The most complicated diseases are not linear, are highly non-linear. Yet, here another point is when you use a very correct simulation platform, we use for example Bioinformatics and Calculus, this is extremely good for having discrete biological mechanisms running in parallel. You can see it as a graph. The main thing that people are not working with that is that they neglect the time dependency. So they cannot synchronize the different cells inside this graph. This is crucial. This took us more than 4 or 5 years or so. So, let's go again. The fourth stage. The fourth stage is that you have the mathematical model and the function creation. The first mathematical models have very, very low, are very low in if we achieve something around 55%, then we are more than that. If you have more than less than 50%, it's for damage. What can we do with that? We try to use the computational tools and the simulation techniques and reverse engineering techniques to add the things that are missing in order to be more reliable and more reliable. The level that we start thinking about the application is when we reach 75%. So, what helps very much for that is that we use for this two things. One is we are in the position of the last year to have our own data collection, or to produce a data collection, because we are up to now very highly funded and highly connected to other labs for the world. And this gives us a great opportunity of having data that are testing the model. And the other thing is that as a test we are trying to have this model produce the need for other biomarkers. So it's not only the idea of new biomarkers are entering the scene, are entering in the system, but also we can find the gaps of existing biomarkers that are produced. Finishing that, what we have arrived, in a new notion, of biomarkers. So what we really have done is that we took vector spaces, we were working on them and we see through non-linear local model that a system of biomarkers is governing the evolution of the biological mechanism. And we know also their exact function. This is not a biomarker, this is not a set of biomarkers, this is the definition of meta biomarkers. So what you really are achieving is that you have the meta biomarkers that are running through each biological mechanism. What we can do with it? Let us see the biomarker means, so that what really this means and what other people are doing up to now. What are they doing in precision medicine? Can one biomarker think working in oncology research in neurodegeneration over the various diseases. So even if you put together a lot of biomarkers, then they are trying to solve it linearly, which is also crazy. Because you take data evolving in a real world in a linear manner, and you try to make correlations in statistics. This is a very important. So the data combinations is after now what all they are doing, because this was extremely underlined that genetics programs are many extremely good neuroscientists. I'm working with we're working with that.
So he's following circuits in the neural system.
What is most interesting is that there was the notion in 2006 of dynamical biomarkers. This was introduced in a very weird lecture by Presley. He was defining that we have to look at biomarkers concerning house, bifurcation, stability, etc. You said all these things. He wrote a lot of money on mathematics, so he did not understand that fractals, he said. He did not understand that house and fractals had nothing to do with the characteristic properties of biomarkers or sets of biomarkers. But he was correct. He was having the feeling that we can work on the set of biomarkers and having characteristics. What is the main characteristic? If you work with the bifurcation diagrams, it's the diagram that produced the whole set of solution as a map after solving the equation from the equation before, then you can see the stability. So this is very crucial for what we are doing, because we can see from the bifurcation diagrams exactly the areas of stabilities that gives you the classification of the different cases of each biological mechanism. So you can have four different types of stability and instability mathematics. The best is areas of asymptotic stability. When you say asymptotic stability mathematics, then it's the most probable thing, it's stable, and asymptotic stability gives you the areas that they will remain stable for a long time period. Okay. The regions of stability have to be defined. So we have regions of stability inside where you can feel safe inside and you can be at the borders. Okay. If you are at the border, then soon you will be at risk. It's the region of stability. Concerning that of saying that in flight function, what we mean is that the disease is present. You can see it, you can detect it, you can see it in the real world. Yet, it has a rate of progression. This rate of progression, namely the former stage of stability, is not very high. And we have regions of blow up. In mathematics, it means that the supremum norma tends to be very highly close to infinity. In a very determined blow up time. Things are collapsing. This is an example showing areas of stability and instability in the model that we are working on concerning Alzheimer's disease. So you can see that this is the transport that we are talking about. This is the transport. Okay. And you have areas of asymptotic stability very near the verification diagram. We have areas of stability everywhere that is bounded up and low bounded, and then we have areas of stability. The areas of blow up is when you have you are in the most high levels, where you can see that this is a small part of the flight function, so the when you go up, the verifications. The verification shows you that you can have very high values for the set of biomarkers, and yet you can be in certain areas. This is crucial. This is the mathematical meaning of what is happening mainly in complicated disease generation, where you can see that all the medical test gives you very high values of the biomarker, and yet you have not the symptoms of the disease. What is going on when all the mathematics go bad? This was another 5-6 years problem. What we have done is that we were working concentrated on the evaluation of the mathematical model. So what if we cannot derive the mathematical model? So how we are working if the process is insufficient from any reason, from human reasons, from mathematical reasons, from data, anyway. But what is going on if we have models that are given 55% QRC, which is nothing to set in the application, and goes on after 5 years of work, like that. What we have done, and now what it is, we have derived metadata on the meta biomarkers. I believe that you have all worked with metadata in the reference business, the bibliography. So what we are doing, we have not written the paper, we are seeing before in the database the tapping board or model for 15 metadata on the paper. You say the author, etc., etc. But it's exactly this, talking for the meta biomarkers, is that we can count characteristics on the set of those meta biomarkers and then follow exactly the set. For set, the set of the metadata of the meta biomarkers. Can this be done? There I have to say the work that Professor Poirazi, Professor Poirazi, is doing in the last years. This is mainly the way that I got the professor of Laurier. So it's considered a mathematician, but he's doing very sophisticated function analysis. So what he mainly does is doing meta programming. So he has programs that are doing programs for the metadata, for the metadata. But this is what he's doing. So what we have achieved is that we take the meta biomarkers, we derive the characteristic metadata, and then he's making scripts working for filling up all the data inside that are missing. And this is going through, he's doing that with very specific tools, sorry, development, or put you better in contact with. Yes, at his level, we were interested in the world. And he's trying to fill in the gaps, so he's giving us different normal cases as decision maps, as decision trees, so that we describe the different cases that those characteristics can work. So we cannot see exactly the biological mechanism, we cannot be sure for what is going, but at the end of this work, you can see the different cases that may exist. So what we are going to do after that, we take those cases and see if there is a person in the Swiss national system that is already found with them. So it's an empirical proof of this can happen. The main problems that we are dealing with. It's the first is the representation of biological data. This is a huge problem. It takes us a lot of time to reproduce all the biological data in order to make them used by the PC. You have seen a lot of that with the bioinformatics approach. The second that is really a problem is that, for example, another research project that we have had in the last 3 years is, 4 years, is that we mainly have energy versus topology or vice versa. This is the problem that we're dealing with protein swapping. So in protein swapping, we have a lot of problem of seeing what is related with that. So what we are really doing is going to RNA secondary structures, so this is we're going to add a secondary structure with this data and we'll try to see how the energy can affect the topology and give us a mathematical criterion done by the computer in this quite the third, we don't have reliable assumption of the evolution of biological mechanisms. This is also a future problem. We do not have a shortage of three cases or analysis of existing volume. We cannot really do data processing in real time. In what we are doing, we can now do it, and due to the help of the analysts and the size of the organs. We can then have media applications and classified sets of data of sophisticated and sophisticated computational tools. This is the main mistakes of the informaticians. They keep the data, they keep it to keep learning, they keep that they are the conclusion, most of them are so. How to follow up the progression of the mechanism. And the other thing is how, this is very important, how you can follow not the normal things but the abnormal. For example, for the protein folding problems, there are people who will be 30, 40 years to understand the folding problem with no success, while they can derive the results from the misfolding problem with success. So the link, which is, I think, a marker that you should do the right thing before you go down the analysis, is not a problem in my case. The main goals that we are trying to see is a new definition of what a health people is. This is important. So the way we work with the biomarkers and the computational biomarkers, the system of biomarkers, is that it is not healthy when we can find that all biomarkers are going very long 10 years before. This is the main problem with the diseases. The metadata estimation of this disease progression can help us a lot. It enables to shape conclusions concerning at risk state. It could not be diagnosed, but at risk state can be achieved by that. We can have a sorting of discrete cases in both, in both successful, in the successful mathematical modeling to solve the problem. And when you are a sufficient, have a sufficient mathematical model, you have solving the discrete cases. You have to arrange again the definition of specificity. You have to define again the specificity. This is very crucial, because especially in the pharmaceutical industry, they have thrown a lot of useful drugs by not clarifying the specificity. Because if you have, for example, through an FDA diet, something that has a specificity of 0.05% of the amount that has to check it that it's forbidden to keep it, the best thing is to find the 0.05% in the 36 million that have a sign. To use it, it will check. And the third thing, the final impact that we need to describe the function. Two words about the computational neurodegeneration. This is a new work that we are trying to do. This is has started from January of 2018. And it's a most inviting to contribute because it is a contract with Springer. With 55 different chapters that I can send them to you. And we have as a first stage to produce in the next 5 years 5,500 pages of papers. The interesting thing about that is that in this handbook, you can have your application immediately uploaded in a provision letter system. It's called Metro. So if you pass through the viewer's phase, then you do not have to wait for the final application of the time. This is the editor. And this is the sensor that I was telling you with years of ideas and Yannis Dalana together. You can only tell us for that. This is the forms that is that we're writing about in November. But they say they sponsor, they are getting a lot of money, but the main thing is the storage inside. We can examine specificity and efficacy of drugs that all have already been thrown away. It is strong in the main problems. Thank you very much. what are you doing when you have unhandled state biomarkers and you get them? Because we have feature selection in the first set. And then we like to apply it to a network which is what is going on in the classic way. Is that right?
In the answer to the
biomarkers as the exosomes of the capillaries. What they have seen is that